Welcome back to another video. As you guys can see by the title, we are playing with the new Carnival 3 collection. This is the Love Tahiti collection with Be Perfect Cosmetics and Stacy Marie. You guys, I'm so excited for today's video. I love the way this look turned out. What do you guys think about today's makeup look? I think it is absolutely stunning. Girl, this collection was so hard to get your hands on, okay? I was actually signed up to get early access. You were actually able to sign up to be able to get early access. Of course, I did because I'm a fiend like that when it comes to makeup. And girl, that day when you got the link, their website ended up crashing. I was heartbroken. I was like, oh my goodness. What is going on? There was just so many people trying to get that early access that the website ended up crashing. Apparently, they didn't correctly anticipate how many people were actually going to be trying to get their hands on this collection. Thankfully, my girl here on YouTube, Gigi Girl, if it wasn't for her, I would have no idea that people were actually being able to check out. So she actually hit me up in the morning and she's like, hey girl, like, did you order your collection? Like, did you get anything? And I'm like, no, like, I cannot even get on the website. And she was like, I was like, did you get anything? And she was like, yeah, I was able to order my stuff. Like, it took some time and, you know, it was acting up, but I was able to get what I wanted. And I was like, oh my god, that means that when I get on, by the time I get through, it's gonna be sold out. What am I gonna do? Mind you, that day I was getting ready to film a YouTube video. I was been supposed to be getting ready to film, and like, I just could not get off the site. I kept refreshing. That like ruined my entire day. Thankfully, I was finally able to get the bundle, and not even me, you guys. Thankfully, Babe was able to pick it up for me. She's amazing. She's always on top of every single makeup launch. So she was able to get it on the site and get me the entire bundle, which was so sweet of her because I wasn't even gonna get the entire bundle, to be honest. But she got it for me, and I am just like over the moon excited. When she sent me the picture, I was like, you did not. And she did. So I do have everything in the collection to share with you guys for today's video. So I'm gonna be swatching the highlighters, I'm gonna be swatching the glosses. I do see your comments when you're like, girl, can you give us some swatches? Like, we want to see what it looks like. The only thing that I'm not going to be swatching is the eyeshadow palette. And honestly, you guys, that's simply because I just don't want to ruin my own palette. You know, like, I just don't want to destroy my palette. And I feel like there's like a bajillion swatches online of the eyeshadow palette anyways. So yeah, I'm not going to be swatching the palette, but I am swatching the highlighters and the glosses for you guys today. So I really hope you guys enjoy this makeup look. Let me know what you guys think about it. And did you guys peep? I'm wearing a pink highlighter. Yes. So I wasn't even gonna get the pink highlighter, so thankfully she got me the entire bundle because I've never worn a colored highlighter. I'm usually a gold highlighter kind of girl. Like, I was like, oh my god, like, are they gonna launch a regular highlighter? Like, are they only launching colorful highlighters? And then I was like, you know what, let me try out the pink one because the eyeshadow, like, it would just match, you know. Girl, when I put this highlighter on my face, I was like, whoa. It's like such a beautiful wearable pink, you guys, and it is beaming. I am obsessed. So yeah, that's everything about the collection. So really quickly, I want to show you guys what the eyeshadow palette looks like, even though, like I said, you've probably seen it online already, but girl, I'm way too excited right now. I need to show you what this looks like. So here's what the cover of the eyeshadow palette looks like. It is so beautiful, you guys. Oh my goodness. They really did put a lot of effort into this packaging, especially because you guys know the Carnival XL Pro has like basic packaging. This is freaking stunning. Like, guys, every time I open this palette, I'm like, wow, this is incredible. Like, how did Stacy even think to create a palette like this? Literally, this is me in an eyeshadow palette. I am so obsessed. The colors are absolutely gorgeous. The layout is beautiful. And you guys, honestly, I used a lot of shades in this palette today. I used 9 eyeshadows for today's look, which I feel like is a good amount to really give you guys an honest review, which obviously you guys can already tell I absolutely love it. But yeah, I wanted to use as many shades as possible. I feel like, why not? You know what I'm saying? I want to really see how the formula is. In a most recent video of mine where I was thanking you guys for 4,000 subscribers, I actually mentioned in that video that I was going to be having a giveaway coming up for 4K, of course. And you guys, this giveaway, epic. Okay, you're not ready. So I was thinking about the giveaway and I was like, what should I give away? I did think about giving away like an Ulta gift card or a Sephora gift card. And then I was like, what's on the market right now that everybody's gonna want to get their hands on? And I was like, the Carnival 3. Hello. So of course, when the official launch day came, which was on a Friday, I did end up going on the site to order one of these babies for one of you guys. So one of you guys are going to be able to win the Carnival 3 Love Tahiti palette. I hope you guys are excited for this giveaway because I am super excited for this giveaway. This palette is absolutely gorgeous. And honestly, you guys, I wish I could have bought more. I would have loved to give away like 3 or 4 eyeshadow palettes, but I was only able to get one, which is fine. I really hope you guys appreciate this giveaway as much as I appreciate you guys. I'm so thankful to every single one of you, and honestly, I just wanted to be able to give back, and I felt like this was the perfect way to do so. So let's get into the giveaway rules really quickly. So rule number one, as always, you must be subscribed to my YouTube channel. Rule number two, you definitely have to be following me on Instagram. You guys, I am going to be checking to make sure you are following all the rules. Also, you have to give this video a huge thumbs up. That really, really helps me out. And the last rule, rule number three, is going to be down below in the comments, leave me a comment letting me know what winning this eyeshadow palette would mean to you. And you guys, please, this is super, super important. With your comment, please do not forget to leave your Instagram name down below with your comment. I need your Instagram handle, you guys, because that's the way I'm going to be reaching out to the winner to let them know they won and to get all the necessary information that I'm going to need to ship out your palette if you win. So please do not forget to leave your Instagram down below. It's just easier for me to reach out via DM. So if you guys don't have Instagram, unfortunately, you cannot enter this giveaway. I am so, so sorry. In the future, there will be more giveaways and I'll figure out another way to be able to choose a winner that doesn't have anything to do with Instagram. But for now, it's easiest for me. It's convenient. So that's the way I'm going to do this giveaway. So yeah, I'm really excited for this giveaway. I hope you guys are too. Girl, this palette is so amazing. Like, you definitely need it. So definitely enter this giveaway. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and jump into today's video. Before we jump in, please don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you guys have not already, especially if you want to enter the giveaway. And because I do post a new video 2 days a week, Mondays and Fridays, you guys definitely don't want to miss out on a new video, so be sure to subscribe. And as always, if you guys would like to see how I created this makeup look right here, also if you want to see swatches of the highlighters, swatches of the glosses, the palette up close, then of course, as always, just keep on watching. Okay, you guys, so I'm gonna get started by priming my lids with the P. Louise base in the shade Rumor Number 2. And I do like to dot this all over my lid. I do put on a generous amount of this base because I do want it to actually completely cover the lid for me. And then I am gonna be blending it out with a Morphe brush. And with this specific base, I did wanna mention that you wanna blend it out until it's no longer shiny, if that makes sense. Because if it's shiny, that means it's way too wet still and it's not blended enough. And when you go in with your shadows, it is gonna get muddy and it's gonna blend in with that base, and you don't want that. So just a heads up. So jumping right into the palette, of course, I needed to give you guys an overview of what the cover looks like as well as what the inside looks like. It is freaking stunning, you guys. Like, this palette is gorgeous. And the first color we're going to be dipping into is a shade called Mango, which is that beautiful bright orange. And with this color, I'm going to be putting this in the inner part of the socket of my eye. So right into that crease area, right where I have that dip in my eye, I'm going to be applying this shade with a nice big fluffy brush. And as always, I'm just worried about building the intensity of the colors first. So then I'm going to go into the shade called Sundown, and I'm going to be using this right towards like the middle of my eye, if that makes sense. So right after that brighter orange. And I'm doing the same exact thing with this color as well, just worrying about really building that intensity and packing it on. So please do not worry about blending if you're going to recreate this look, because that is not the main focus at the moment. So now we're going to go in with a shade called Pink Lily, which is actually pinker than what it looks on camera, to be honest, but it does have a really beautiful purple undertone. And I'm going to put that in the outer part of the eye. And then I'm going to go in with a shade called Grape, which is a deeper purple. And this is what's going to give us that really beautiful intensity on the outer corner. And this is the shade that I'm going to use to really create that outer rounded shape as well. So that's what I'm doing here, just packing on that color. And then what I'm going to do is take this same fluffy brush and just run it on my color switch pan. And I'm basically, with no eyeshadow on here, I'm going to start to blend out the edges of these shadows just to kind of get them to work into the eye, that when we go in with the rest of the colors, it's not too difficult to start to blend them out. I've been doing this technique lately and it really has been working for me, so definitely give it a try. So the next color I'm going to be dipping into is a shade called Pink Lily. We're going to go back into that pinkish purple shade, and this is going to go right on that that outer corner of the eye. This is actually going to help to blend out that grape shade. And this color combo is absolutely gorgeous. And then I'm going to go in to the shade Blackberry, which is all the way on the bottom of the palette. You actually can't even see me pointing to it, so I apologize. And this is what's going to give us that depth on the outer corner. So I am going in with that with a nice fluffy brush and really building that intensity. So the next shade I'm going to be using is the shade Lilac, which is that beautiful lilac color, obviously. And I'm actually going to be using this to diffuse that pink lily shade that we used right on that outer portion of the eye. And then I just took a clean fluffy brush and just went ahead and went over everything so everything looks nice and blended, and it really does look really diffused going up towards the brow bone. I kind of really like that look, and I really wanted to go for that look for today's eyes. And then I did go back in and just build up the intensity of the purple so it didn't get lost. Okay, so now it's time for the fun part, which is cutting the crease. I'm going to go in with the Garnier Micellar Water and just a few Q-tips. And what I like to do is basically carve out that cut crease with the Q-tip. I do usually go through about maybe 5 or 6 Q-tips doing this method, but you guys, it really does make a huge difference in your cut crease, especially if you want a really clean, crisp cut crease. So you want to make sure all of that shadow is off of there, because then what's going to happen is it's going to mix with your base, create its own color, and then whatever color you put on top of the base, it's not going to be true to color. How many times did I just say color? But you guys get what I'm saying. So once all of that shadow is off of the lid, now we can actually go in and cut the crease. This is the P. Louise base with Mitchell in the shade Blank Canvas. This is my go-to. I cannot live without this product. There is no cut crease without Blank Canvas. Okay, so right here, what you guys are seeing me do is actually cut out that really sharp edge in my inner corner, but I did blend out Blank Canvas because this does dry down very quickly and you will not be able to move that and it'll just look super awkward. So I did just take a moment to just blend that out, and then girl, I just went in and cut my crease. Nothing new here. You guys have seen me do this a million times. And then of course I just went in and made sure my base was all over the lid and everything was nice and smooth and padded out, so that way when we go in with shadow, everything is nice and smooth and nothing skips, if that makes sense. So you definitely want to make sure you have a nice layer of this on the lid. So of course, as always, the first shade I'm going to be going into is that purple shade, which is the shade Blackberry. And what I'm going to do is take this on a fluffy brush and just start to pack it onto the outer corner. So I'm not rubbing it, I'm not swiping it, I'm packing it on, because keep in mind that base is still a little bit tacky and you want it to look nice and even. So this is the best way to get that look. And then I'm going to go into the shade Pink Lily, and this color is going to go right over that purple. So 50% on the purple and 50% on the base itself. You kind of want to start to create that ombre. So doing it this way is definitely going to make it super easy and super simple to achieve that really blended look. So the next color I'm going to go back into is the shade called Sundown, which is that darker orange. But I did want to show you guys the reality of using this base real quick. It does crease very quickly, so you do have to go back in and just blend it out. So I just want to give you guys a heads up, because if you go in and you decide to put the shadow over the crease, your shadow is going to look super creasy and you do not want that. So I'm doing the same thing with the orange. I'm basically doing the same method with all the shades. So I'm going in with that darker orange. And then of course I'm going to go into the shade yellow, and this is going to be the last color I'm putting on the actual lid itself, and this is going to go right above that orange. So super beautiful, all colors that blend really well together. And then for that inner corner, we're going to go in with the Riviera palette. Are you surprised? This is my favorite white eyeshadow of all time. If you are new to my channel, it is super bright, super beautiful, and I'm just going to pop this right in that inner corner and of course drag it down towards the side of my nose. So I did go in with this brow brush from Anastasia. It's just a really fine angle brush, just to make sure that inner corner was nice and defined. So moving on to lashes, I'm going to be using the lashes from this collection. These are in the style Tahiti, of course. So these lashes were actually really beautiful, super fluffy. So really quickly, I'm just going to prep my lashes with some mascara. This obviously, of course, is the KKW Beauty Mascara. It is my favorite. So I'm really quickly just going to go ahead and give myself a good coat of that. And then we can go ahead and pop on the lashes. So I'm going to go ahead and apply it to the center of my lid, then go ahead and glue down that outer corner, then inner corner. And these lashes were super easy to work with and I really did enjoy them. I'm definitely going to be using them more often. So that's it for the top of the eye. Let's go ahead and move on to the face makeup. So to give my skin a little bit of hydration, I'm going to go in with the 4th Ray Face Milk. This one is the coconut one. Super amazing. I have been loving these face milks, you guys. They're really nice on the skin and give you such a beautiful glow. And then for primer, I'm going to go in with my Milk Hydro Grip Primer, one of my favorite primers of all time. Super amazing gripping primer. This really does make your makeup last all day. And then for foundation, I'm going to be mixing two foundations today. I'm mixing the Pure 4-in-1 Love Your Selfie with the Bite Beauty Changemaker Foundation. And I don't know what it was. I was just feeling like mixing these two today. And girl, it was a match made in heaven. So if you guys have both of these foundations in your collection, definitely mix them because it's gonna be a dream on your skin, okay? And then to blend it out, I am gonna be using my e.l.f. Total Face Sponge. And guys, I'm still shook at how amazing this combo was. I am so in love, and the colors were perfect for my skin. So what I like to do is take that same Morphe brush and just blend out the foundation in between my brows because I do not want to mess up the brows. And then to go ahead and do some cream bronzing, I'm using this Chanel cream bronzer, and I'm so mad that I like this so much, guys, because it is so expensive. But this is the Chanel Soleil Tan Bronzer, I believe, and it's expensive as hell. I'm gonna tell you that right now, but it is so good. I love it. So for concealer, I'm going in with the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. Mine is in the shade NC25. Wow, guys, this concealer is absolutely freaking beautiful. So I like to actually apply this with a brush anywhere that I'm actually gonna apply concealer. And then really quickly, I'm gonna show you guys my setting powder, because you guys know once I blend, girl, we need to set right away. So like I was saying, I like to actually apply it with the brush, and then I do blend it out with my e.l.f. Total Face Sponge. I just feel like it's the easiest way to kind of work with this concealer. I really wish it came with like a doe foot applicator, but I can completely look past the packaging because the formula is incredible. So I'm using that concealer today, and then I'm going in with my Collab Set the Stage Translucent Powder. Such an amazing powder. This is going to be one of the first powders I ever completely finished, which is crazy to say because I have so many powders, but this one is truly amazing. It makes your skin look airbrushed. And then talking about airbrush, I'm going to be going in with the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Powder. This one is in the shade Medium, and I'm going to use this to set the rest of my face. And this powder is really beautiful as well, and I just wanted to use some different products. I feel like I use the same thing on my channel all the time, so I thought I'd change it up for today. So for bronzer, I'm going to be using the MAC Give Me Sun Bronzer. Yes, I am whipping this baby back out. It is such a beautiful bronzer, and I'm just using my same old jumbo Jaclyn Hill brush, and I like to pat on my bronzer, and then I go ahead and blend it out once I feel like that cream bronzer is nice and set. So I'm going to be bronzing my cheeks, my forehead, of course, and because everything today is super sleek, I did want to have my cheekbones look really sharp, so I am going to clean up that bronzer just a little bit, just a tiny bit. And while that is setting, I'm gonna go in with some blush. So this is the Pro Fusion blush palette. I'm gonna be mixing those two shades. You guys, the pigment of this blush palette is absolutely insane. If you are at your local Walmart and you guys have this palette, definitely pick it up. So that's it for the face. So let's go ahead and move back into the lower lash line. So I'm going to be going back in to the shade Blackberry, and I'm going to take that on a flat definer brush as per usual, and I'm going to pack this on my lower lash line. And then to blend that out, I'm going to go back into the shade Pink Lily with a really tiny small blending brush, and I'm going to go ahead and diffuse that purple just because I want to make sure that it blends really well with that outer corner and just kind of make everything look nice and cohesive from top to bottom, if that makes sense. And then I'm going to go back in to the shade Mango and Sundown, but I'm first going to go into Mango, and I'm going to take that on the flat definer brush. I'm doing the same thing that I did with the other two colors. So I'm going to pack on that Mango shade, and then with a tiny blending brush, I'm going to go ahead and blend it out with the color Sundown just to make sure everything looks nice and blended. And then of course I'm going to go back into that white shade from the Riviera palette, and I'm going to pop that right back into the inner corner because it does get lost with you applying foundation and everything like that. So I went ahead and did that really quickly so that inner corner looks nice and bright. And then of course we have to add something to the waterline. And for the waterline, I'm going to go in with two ColourPop cream gel liners. So this one here was like a brighter yellow, super beautiful. I'm going to leave both of the shade names down below. And then I went in with this more orange one towards the inner part of the eye. Now, to go ahead and set these two shades, I am going to go in with that bright green color in the palette. Super, super beautiful, super vibrant. And I'm taking this on a small brush, and I'm just basically packing that on. So not only is it going to help to set the liner in place, but it's going to give it that really beautiful neon color, which I think went perfect
like for today's look. And that's basically it, you guys. I'm going to go ahead and take that same KKW Beauty Mascara, give myself a good coat of mascara on the lower lashes, and now we can move on to the fun part. Let's get into some swatching of these highlighters. So here's what the highlighters look like. Here's the packaging, and then I did also want to show you the outside. Super beautiful. I am obsessed. So this first one right here is called Hollow Glaze. It's a beautiful pink highlighter, but it does have a little bit of a shift of purple. You guys, these are so reflective. I'm absolutely in love with this shade. I think it is so beautiful. And then this next shade right here is the shade called Skin Sheen. And this one right here has a beautiful like gold blue shift. Absolutely stunning. And then this next shade here is called Do You. Also super, super beautiful. Absolutely in love with this shade as well. And then the next shade we have here is the shade called Soft Silk. And this is the beautiful gold shade. And that is the last highlighter in the collection. So for my face today, girl, I decided let's do something different. I'm going to go in with the shade Hollow Glaze. It is a beautiful pink purple color, as you guys saw by the swatch. And Stacy did recommend to actually apply it with a wet beauty blender. Girl, I was shook. I had to leave this part in because I went from shook to like feeling myself. I was like, ooh, girl, this highlighter is beaming. So super, super beautiful. I'm absolutely in love with the formula, you guys. It is so wet looking. It has the perfect name. I am obsessed. So highlighter is on. Let's go ahead and move on to the glosses. So these are all the glosses. Let's get into swatching them. So this first shade here is the shade Petticoat, which is super beautiful. It's such a bright, vibrant pink, you guys, and the swatch, I was blown away. This is just one layer of this gloss. It is absolutely incredible. The next shade that I have here is the shade called Sweet Spot, and that's that super beautiful, vibrant coral shade. Also another super pigmented color. With one swipe, you get full-on pigment. So that one is gorgeous as well. The next color in the collection is this beautiful blue. This one is called Ink, and this one I was actually expecting it to be way more pigmented, but it's not. It's actually more of a sheer blue, which is probably nice. It's not too intense and scary. And then this shade right here is called Girl Code. Super beautiful as well, but it was also super, super sheer. I was definitely not expecting that either. So definitely so happy I was able to swatch these for you guys. And then the last one, of course, is my favorite. This is the shade Starkers, I believe that's how you pronounce it. Super beautiful nude, you guys. I am obsessed. I'm gonna be using this so much, so just prepare yourself. So now we can move into actually doing the lips. So I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips with the KKW Beauty lip liner in the shade Nude Number 2. Nothing new here, I know. I need to find a new favorite lip liner, to be honest. Let me know your favorite lip liners down below. Nice nude colors, please. Let a girl know, because I need a new one. So I went ahead and lined my lips with that. Of course, I'm gonna go in with my Laura Lee Los Angeles liquid lipstick in the shade Nakey Nakey, and then in the center of my lips I'm actually gonna go in with the Jeffree Star liquid lipstick in the shade I'm Nude. Really beautiful pale nude, and I'm just gonna go ahead and blend that out with my finger. Nothing fancy. And then we can go in with the gloss. So I went ahead and just patted the gloss right in the center of my lips, and then I patted it out with my finger. Super, super beautiful gloss, you guys, and it's not sticky, which I love. So to finish off this makeup look, I'm gonna go ahead and set my face with a Glow Recipe Watermelon Glow Mist, and that is basically it. Your look is complete at this point. I'm so obsessed with this makeup look, you guys. I hope you are too. As always, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Thank you for your love and support, and please do not forget to enter the giveaway. All the rules will be down below in the description box, so be sure to check there, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!